And we welcome you back here to Steelman Fieldhouse as we get set for men's action here tonight. Glad you're with us on this Thursday night. It's going to be every Thursday and Saturday throughout the month of January and February. We'll have UAM basketball, both men's and women's. Earlier this evening, if you're just joining us, it was a 75-58 decision for Northwest Oklahoma State as the Lady Rangers defeated the Blossoms here in the first game. Here in the second game of the doubleheader, the men get set to go on. Northwest Oklahoma State comes in at 3-7 overall. They are 1-3 in conference play. Almost mirrors the Weevils. They are 3-6 overall and 1-3 coming into tonight's ball game. Again, there's no students on campus, or just a few students on campus. They won't be back until next Wednesday, but we've got ball games here again on Saturday. So I hope if you're around town on Saturday, you want to come out. 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock Saturday afternoon. It'll be Southwest Oklahoma State coming to town. That'll be Saturday afternoon, 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock. Of course, if you can't make it out, you can listen right here to KHBM 93.7 FM. I'm Jimmy Sledge. And both teams are out preparing to get set for basketball here tonight. Tell you what, we'll take a quick break, and then we'll come back, and we'll have a look at the starters for you for both ball clubs when we return in just a moment.
Thank you.
And we welcome you back to Steelman Fieldhouse as we get set for men's action on the Great American Conference style. The Weevils taking on the Rangers of Northwest Oklahoma State. Looking at, first of all, the starters for the Rangers. They will start at point guard, Kennedy Milton. At guard, Brian Free. Another guard, Larry White. At forward, Marcus Milton. And the big guy in the middle is going to be Kabia Chibanga. For the Weevils, Isaac Jackson, Josh Denton, Wesley Booker, Zane Nelson, and Tamir Kupalia going to get to start for the Weevils here tonight. So Coach Chad Tapp, in his third season here at UAM, comes in 3-6 on the year, 1-3 in conference play. Northwest Oklahoma State comes in 3-7 and 1-3. Again, they turn the lights out and get set to introduce the Weevils here this evening. And then we'll be set for basketball action. Jason, I tell you what, we'll take another timeout and we'll come back with a start of a nice ball game after this. As we welcome you back to Steelman Fieldhouse, Northwest won the opening toss. A quick foul was called against the Weevils on Josh Denton. They put up a shot now. It's no good. Weevils have the rebound. We're at action. 19 and a half minutes to play here in the first half. Scoreless, Weevils first offensive possession. Kupalia out on the left elbow. Goes top of the key to Booker. Booker swings it right side. Turnaround jumper. Good by Zane Nelson. Nelson gives the Weevils the early lead here on their first offensive possession as he knocks it down. Rangers will have it front court. Kennedy Milton runs the point. They run it off. Marquise Milton. Milton back out top of key to Milton. Long three-pointer on the wing. Good by Brian Free. So already a lead change. 3-2. Rangers with the one-point lead. They'll apply some pressure in the backcourt after a made basket. Zane Nelson comes to, gets it across the timeline for the Weevils. Directing traffic. Now to Booker. Wesley Booker, they get it out front to Josh Denton. Denton to Booker. Left side to Isaac Jackson. Isaac fadeaway jumper from the left side from 12. No good. We got a rebound. Jump ball call. Alternating possession going to belong to the Weevils as Josh Denton tied it up on the inside on the rebound. And the Weevils are going to get it back with 18:20 to play in the half. Rangers lead at 3-2 here in the early going. In the deep right corner, long three-pointer by Nelson's up, no good. Rebound, Rangers have it. Shitsabanga. They had the rebound, they work it around the perimeter. Weevils, and a man-to-man. We're going to have a whistle, an offensive foul going to be called against the Rangers, Larry White. Maybe a good bit of acting there by the Weevils. We'll take the charge and be the first personal, first team foul against the Rangers. First personal against Larry White. And again, pressure in the backcourt by Northwestern. Zane Nelson trying to bounce pass. Ball's going to be kicked. As the ball got kicked, UAM will take it out back on the baseline again. They look to get it in. They get it into Denton. Denton off to Nelson. Back to Denton. Josh into the front court. Across the timeline. We will set up in their half-court offense. They go to Booker. Wesley deep on the right wing. Rangers in a man-to-man. They go to Kupalia. Back to Booker. Seven to shoot. Kupalia looking out front to Denton. Denton couldn't get the shot off. Drives. Fadeaway jumper. Good. With 1 second on the shot clock, Josh Denton knocks down the jumper. Weevils lead it by one, 4-3. Quickly, here comes the Rangers. They'll take it. Go inside the paint. Brian Free kicks it back outside to Milton. Milton guarded out there by Josh Denton. He'll leave it out front now with Brian Free, who's guarded by Zane Nelson. Nelson, they go down the right side. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Weevils with four on the shot clock. The Rangers will have it on the baseline. And 4 seconds remain on the shot clock. They'll look to get it in on the baseline. Goes deep out in the front court. Get it to Free. Free, a quick shot from almost midcourt. Nails the three. Oh, man, back-to-back threes by Brian Free. And it's a 6-4 ball game. Our third lead change already in this one. 16:47 to play, first half. Weevils. Josh Denton out left side, top of the key, swing it right side to Jackson. Isaac back up to Denton. Denton goes left side now to Booker. Booker, top of the key to Jackson. Nelson has it knocked away from behind, stolen by Larry White. He'll take it down, lay it up and in. Good. Larry White for the Rangers. They double up the Weevils, 8-4. 16-19 left to play in the first half. Weevils break the press, get it into the front court. UAM will try to set up in their half court here. They go to Jackson, Isaac. Isaac takes the dribble, goes down into the paint, kicks it out in the corner to Denton for three. Josh misses, no good. Battle for the rebound. Wesley Booker chases it down for UAM, and they'll reset. Good hustle on the offensive boards that time by the Weevils. Get it off to Nelson. Nelson drives baseline, left corner to Denton for three. Again, this one's good. Josh Denton pulls the Weevils to within one. It's 8-7. 15:30 left to play in the first half. Milton clears it right side to Brian Free. Free down low to Larry White. White backing in there against Wesley Booker. Spin move in the paint. No good. Off the mark. Denton with a rebound for the Boll Weevil. Weevils down by one. Denton to Nelson. Now to Booker. Wesley Booker, top of the key, swings it right side to get it to Jackson. Isaac going to dribble, takes it all the way down to the baseline. The floater down there is no good. Rebound comes away to the Rangers. Coming away the rebound, Shisabango. He'll have it here on the right side as he goes down working against Kupalia. Throw it back out front. Another long three-pointer on the way. This one's short off the front of the iron. Wesley Booker chases down the rebound for the Boll Weevils. 14:38 to play in the first half. 8-7 Rangers with a one-point lead. Weevils with the basketball in the front court. Rangers staying a man-to-man as the Weevils work it out here on the perimeter. Jackson to Nelson. Under 10 to shoot. They get it to Denton again for three from the left wing. It's no good. Wesley Booker with a long rebound. Tries to go right back in. The ball is kicked out of bounds. It'll stay with the Weevils, but not before we have a timeout. 14-13 left to play in the first half. It is 8-7. The Rangers with a one-point lead over the Weevils. We're back in just a moment. To seven. Weevils trail by one. Rangers are 3 out of 6. 50%, but they're shooting 2 of 3. Made 2 of their 3-pointers. 67% from beyond the arc. Weevils are 3 of 8, 38%, and 1 of 4 from beyond the arc. Neither team's been to the free throw line. Weevils have out-rebounded them here in the early going, 5 to 3. It'll be UAM basketball underneath their own bucket. They get it in. Get it in the corner to Nelson. Nelson right back to Kupalia. His shot up no good. Rebound. Rangers have it. Coming out of there with it, Brian Free. They'll slow it down. He'll leave it out front with Cameron McDowell, who just checked into the ball game for the Rangers. Swing it left side. Now back to McDowell. McDowell goes in with a layup. Rolls out. No good. Rebound. Wesley Booker there to clear the boards for UAM. Denton. Off to Booker, right side to Isaac Jackson, out deep on the right wing. In the corner it goes. That's going to be over to Booker. Back out front now. Go to Nelson. Shot clock down to 10. Nelson directing traffic. Gives it to Kupalia. Back to Nelson. He'll drive. 5 seconds. Reverse layup by Zane Nelson. What a shot. Got it to go, and the Weevils have regained the lead. Our fourth lead change already in the ballgame. 9-8. Weevils on top by one. 13-10 to play. Rangers with the basketball here in the front court. They get it off to Marquise Milton. Milton. He'll give it up out front to McDowell. And now a whistle. Let's see. Going to have a foul called against UAM. And a foul goes on Zane Nelson, his first. Second team foul. It's on the floor. So the Rangers get a fresh 20 on the shot clock. They'll inbound it on the baseline. Checking in for them is Dietrich Paschal. The Rangers get it in. Justin Norris also just checked in for them. For the Rangers. UAM stays in a man-to-man. Alex Brogdon has checked in for UAM. The only substitute in the game at the moment. There's a lot of two-pointer on the way. This one's good, and that was Cameron McDowell just inside the three-point line. 10-9. Rangers with a one-point lead. Weevils break it into the front court. They'll get it off to Josh Denton. Denton to Brogdon. Left side to Jackson. Isaac out on the wing. Down they go to Kupalia. Kupalia gives it up back to Nelson from the free-throw line. His shot no good, but a whistle and a foul called, and he's going to get to go to the free-throw line. As the foul is going to go against Chance Love, his first, second team foul against the Rangers here in the first half. 12-19 to play. 10-9 our score. Rangers with a one-point lead. Zane Nelson at the line shooting 2 free throws. First one's on the way, and it's good. Ties the ball game at 10. Nelson with 5 points already for the Weevils. Second free throw, rattles around, goes down good. 11-10, Weevils up by one, 12-15 to play in the half. Rangers with it front court. McDowell leaves it out front to Paschal. Paschal now off to Norris. Norris back to Yep, that's going to be number three, McDowell. McDowell back out front, three. Thought about shooting the three. Got a whistle, though, and a foul against the Weevils. Foul is going to be on Zane for the Weevils. Zane Nelson, his second personal foul. And we've got a timeout on the floor. 11-10, the Weevils lead it by one. 11:58 left to play here in the first half. We're back with more UAM basketball right after this timeout. It's 11-10, UAM with a one-point lead. It's just under the 12-minute mark here and the first half. UAM 4 of 10, 40%, 1 of 4 from downtown, and 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Northwestern, 4 of 8 from the floor, 50%. They've hit two of their three three-pointers here in the first half. They have not shot a free throw. As we come out of the timeout, Northwest gets the basketball. It's going to be knocked out of bounds. Last touch by UAM. So to stay with the Rangers with 14 seconds on the shot clock. They're going to inbound down there on the baseline. Looking to trigger it in, Brian Free. Goes deep into the backcourt, throws it all the way down the floor to Cameron McDowell. 10 seconds when he crosses the timeline. Travels with the basketball. Drug his pivot foot as he picked up his dribble. And that'll be turnover number three against the Rangers. Weevils with one so far in the ball game. 11:46 to play in the first half. UAM with a one-point lead. 11-10. Anderson checked in at the timeout. He's in there in the post position. Brogdon off to Jackson. Isaac. Penetrates, goes down the right side of the lane, around the screen, gets the layup to go. Isaac Jackson, his first 2 points, leading scorer on this ball club, gives the Weevils a three-point lead. On the other end, turnaround jumper inside the lane, no good by the Rangers. Weevils have the rebound, coming the other way. Nelson gets it off to Booker, Booker to Jackson to Brogdon, out on the right side. Top of the key now to Booker. Back to Nelson. Nelson trying to drive, goes down. Now finds Anderson in the lane. His shot will not go. Rebound. Rangers have it. McDowell into the front court for the Rangers. He'll go right side over to Justin Norris. Norris, they swing it over to the left wing. Get it over there to Free. Back right side now. Oh, underneath in the paint. Ball's loose on the floor. Whistle and a blocking foul called against the Weevils. And I believe they're going to get Cole Anderson with the foul. Let's see who's the foul was on. Fouls against the Weevils, but I'm still waiting to see who they called it on. It may have been on Nelson. As he will go sit down on the bench. Weevils will steal the inbounds pass by the Rangers. As checking in, that was Donovan Cooper who checked in place of Nelson. All right, Weevils with the basketball and a three-point lead. Kupalia checked back in as well. Turnaround jumper by Isaac. Good. Isaac Jackson nails the jumper from just inside the free throw line. Weevils with their biggest lead of the first half at 5, 15-10. We go under 10 minutes left to play in the half. Rangers working around the perimeter. Norris, they go inside the paint. Shabugan, and they call an offensive foul on him. Lowered his shoulder. Gets called for the offensive foul. His first personal third team foul. Weevils get it back with 10 minutes left to play here in the first half. Leading by 5, 15 to 10. Pressure in the backcourt against by the Rangers. Cooper inbounds it to Brogdon. Back to Cooper. Donovan will get it across the timeline as he gets it ahead to Wesley Booker. And Weevils will work it out here on the perimeter. Brogdon to Booker. To Jackson. Trying to go to Kupalia. Ball batted away. It's loose on the floor and a whistle and a reach in foul. Going to be called against the Weevils. It's going to go on Isaac Jackson. That'll be his first. I have that as the fifth team foul against the Weevils. So neither team in the bonus yet, but 9:41 left to play in the first half. 15 to 10. UAM with a 5-point lead. Kennedy Milton will check back in for the Rangers. Weevils have Wesley Booker, Alex Brogdon, Donovan Cooper. And Kupalia on the floor. There's a drive left side by the Rangers. Larry White. White's shot blocked, but a foul called. Oh, no foul called, just a blocked shot out of bounds. Josh Denton's going to check back in. Alex Brogdon will sit down for the Weevils. It'll be Ranger basketball on the baseline. They'll get it in to Larry White. White gives it up, gives it right back to Marquise Milton. Marquise carries the basketball. They don't see that call very much in college anymore. As they carried it, turned it over. And that'll be another turnover against the Rangers here. With 9:21 to play in the half, Weevils leading 15 to 10. Donovan Cooper going to give it up to Isaac Jackson. Jackson to Booker out on the right wing. Top of the key, swing it left side. To Denton, back top side. Now off to Jackson. Isaac takes the dribble. In the corner to Booker. Booker thought about the three. Shot clock at 12. Cooper back to Jackson. Jackson. A give and go. He went in the corner to Booker. Back to Jackson. He'll go in. A whistle and a foul called against the Rangers. Foul is going to go on Shabanga. Shabanga, I have it as his second personal foul. And at the free throw line is Isaac Jackson. He's shooting two shots. Isaac, first one's up and good. And the Weevils have a 6-point lead. Shabanga will check out of the ball game. Butters will check in. Second free throw by Jackson's up, and it is good. 17 to 10, Weevils' biggest lead by either team here in the first half. Just under 9 minutes left to play in the first half. Larry White gives it up away to Kennedy Milton. Milton back out to Butters. Butters, they go right side in the. It's Milton driving baseline, brings it back out with a dribble. They swing it around the perimeter. Milton driving into the paint, dishes it off inside. Whistle, jump ball called as he gets tied up inside by Josh Denton. Alternating possession stays with the Rangers. So Northwest will get it on the baseline. They'll have 10 on the shot clock. They get it into White. White faded away into lane. No good. Rebound Josh Denton for the Boll Weevils. Excuse me, UAM leading 17 to 10. They'll have it here in the front court with 8:20 left to play in the first half. Jackson to Denton to Booker. Booker, top of the key, swings it to Jackson. Isaac, working around the perimeter in the left corner. That's Booker for three, it's no good. Isaac Jackson with an offensive rebound. He gets the ball knocked out of his hand, stolen by the Rangers. Coming down the floor is Brian Free. They leave it outside. Three-pointer on the way is no good. Rebound, going to be out of bounds. No, they called a foul on the Weevils. On a rebound. The foul. How about it on the Rangers on Larry White, his second personal foul. 7:51 to play in the first half. We've got a timeout on the floor. 17-10. The Weevils have a 7-point lead. We'll be back here from Steelman Fieldhouse right after this timeout. The Weevils with a 7-point lead. UAM, I make that to Rangers, shooting 4 of 13, 31% from the floor. UAM 6 of 14, 43%. Weevils are 4 of 4 from the free throw line. Rangers have not shot a free throw here in the first half. And the Weevils have out-rebounded them 10 to 5. Weevils get the basketball out of the timeout. Wesley Booker, Josh Denton, Isaac Jackson, Cole Anderson, and Donovan Cooper on the floor for the Weevils. Rangers have gone to a zone defense, it looks like. Weevils work it in to Booker. Back out front to Cooper. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Donovan gives it to Denton. Denton fires a long three from the left wing. It's off the back of the iron. No good. Wesley Booker went high. Couldn't hold on to the rebound. Now it's a loose basketball. We're going to find up calling a foul on Wesley Booker. Oh, my goodness. There were bodies on the floor, people reaching and scrambling for it, and they called a foul on Wesley Booker. It's going to be his first. Team foul number 6. 7:16 to play in the first half. Neither team's in the 1-1 bonus yet, but Northwest will be there. The next foul against UAM. Rangers have it here in the front court. They get it off Milton, or your right side. Marquise Milton. Now left side, they work it to Kennedy. Shot put up, no good, and a whistle and a foul called inside against the Weevils. Who's going to get this one? Foul is going to go on Cole Anderson. Cole. His first personal, seventh team foul. And going to put it to free throw line, Brian Free. Brian opened up the ball game, hit a couple of quick threes early there in the first half. He's going to be at the line shooting two here. First one's on the way, good. And his first free throw is good, makes it 17-11. Weevils with a 6-point lead. Second free throw's up, and it's good. 17-12. UAM still leads by 5. 6:58 to play in the first half. Donovan Cooper, Isaac Jackson, Josh Denton, Alex Brogdon's into the ball game now, and along with Cole Anderson. Again, they've gone to a zone. The Rangers have working it. They're going to Brogdon at the right elbow. Bounce pass inside the lane to Anderson. Anderson spins. Left-handed hook shots up. Gets the roll. Cole Anderson. Got the shooter's roll as that one went all over the rim. Finally falls through. Back to a 7-point lead now for UAM. Here come the Rangers into the front court. They work it off, get it to Milton. That's Marquise. Back out front now to Norris. Norris fade away from 8. No good. Rebound tipped around by Brogdon. Picked up by Denton. 19-12. Weevils up by 7. We approach 6 minutes left to play in the half. Cooper to Denton. Denton, back to Donovan Cooper. Weevils, they can work it inside, get some success, or they're going to have to hit some outside shots to get the Rangers out of this zone defense. Here's Jackson. They get it in the corner again. That's going to be Denton for 3. It won't go. Long rebound comes back to him, though, over in the left side. Top of the key again. to Jackson, to Cooper, back to Jackson, now left side to Denton. Nine to shoot. Get it to Jackson, this time for three, and it's good.
Isaac Jackson.
His first three. The Rangers call a timeout with 5:27 left to play in the first half. It is 22-12. The Weevils have opened up a 10-point lead over the Rangers. We're going to keep it right here. Don't forget, we're back in action on Saturday. Southwest Oklahoma State will be coming here to Stillman Fieldhouse. 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock are the tip-off times on Saturday, so we invite you to make plans to come out and join us. Of course, if you can't make it, keep it right here on KHPM 93.7, your home of UAM Sports. You're listening to KHPM. And that big three gives by Isaac Jackson gives the Weevils their biggest lead here in the half at 10, 22-12. The Rangers called the timeout there to try to stop the bleeding. They'll come out of the timeout. UAM's got Isaac Jackson, Josh Denton, Donovan Cooper, Alex Brogdon, and Cole Anderson on the floor. For the Rangers, it's Marquise Milton. That's going to be Cameron McDowell. Justin Norris is out there. Also, Brian Free. And then on the inside, Cheval Brothers. 22-12. Weevils lead it by 10. 5:25 left to play in the first half. Kennedy Milton, they give it up. Ball is kicked off the floor. Let's see. Kicked out of bounds. Last touch by Isaac Jackson, they say. So the Rangers will maintain possession. They'll inbound right in front of the UAM pitch. They'll get it in here in the front court. Long three-pointer on the way is good by Cameron McDowell. Third three-pointer by the Rangers. It's 22-15. Weevils still lead by seven. We go under 5 minutes. They try to trap Donovan Cooper at half court. Gets it across the timeline. Weevils will go into their half court offense. They go to Denton out on the left wing. Denton, top of key to Brogdon. Brogdon now to Jackson. Isaac takes the dribble. Going to go inside down the left side of the lane. Shot's partially blocked. Rebound picked up by the Rangers. Here comes Northwestern down the floor. They get it ahead to Justin Norris. Right side off to Marquise Milton. He'll go into the paint. Shot up, blocked by Anderson. They get it back. Three-point shot on the way. Good by Justin Morris. Back-to-back threes has cut it to a four-point ball game. 22-18. Here's Jackson driving the paint. Again, his shot blocked by Butlers. Quickly, a three-pointer on the way on the other end by Northwest is no good. Cooper with a rebound. Outlet pass down the floor. A wide open Isaac Jackson, and he'll stuff it with two hands to slam it home. Isaac with 9 points now in the first half. UAM leads it 24-18. 3:43 to play. Cameron McDowell out front to Kennedy Milton. There's a whistle and an offensive foul going to be called on an illegal screen by Cheval Butters. I have that as his third. They call it the first one on him. All right, his first timeout or his first foul. 3:37 to play in the half. We got a timeout on the floor. 24-18. Weevils lead it. We're back in just a moment.
Thank you.
24-18. The Weevils with a 6-point lead. As we are at the media timeout, 3:37 left to play in the half. Rangers are 6 of 18, 33%, but they're 4 of 5 from three-point land. That's 80%. And they're 2 of 2 from the free throw line. UAM 9 of 21, 43%. Shooting 2 of 8 from downtown. That's 25% and 4 of 4 from the free throw line. UAM has out-rebounded them 13 to 9. 4 offensive and 9 defensive rebounds for UAM. It'll be Weevil basketball. Zane Nelson is checked back in. He's playing with 2 fouls. We're waiting on the officials. They're not sure what they're trying to check on. But Zane Nelson, Alex Brogdon, Isaac Jackson, Josh Denton, and Krupa Leah on the floor for the Bow Weevils. Now the officials are going to send both teams back to the benches. I'm not sure what they're trying to determine. We got 3:37 left to play before halftime. We just went into the media timeout, and they're going to go back and look at the replay for some reason. The officials are talking to Coach Tapp over there. Doesn't look like he's too happy with the explanation that they're giving him. Assistant coach Rodney Clark right there with him. Again, 3:37 to play before halftime. It is 24 to 18. Weevils lead by 6. Biggest lead by 10 here in the first half of UAM. Biggest lead for the Rangers has been 4. Officials are taking their time trying to figure it out. Or whatever it is. Shot clock is at 30. As
they're checking to see if the last 3-pointer they called.
Okay. They were checking to see if the last 3-pointer they called for the Rangers was a 2-pointer. All right. So it's 24-18 on the scoreboard. We're back to action. There we go. UAM will get the basketball out of the timeout. Zane Nelson throws it down the floor. It's off the fingertips, goes out of bounds. Turnover, UAM. 3:29 to play. Rangers will get it back, trailing by 6. There's a steal by Zane Nelson. Nelson down the floor, left-handed layup, misses it, no good. Isaac Jackson got the rebound. He'll kick it in the right corner now to Nelson, and he'll slow it down. Weevils will reset their half-court offense as Nelson's going to control it out here near midcourt. Now gets it to Denton, Denton to Brogdon, Brogdon. Leaves it out front to Nelson. 5 to shoot. Nelson out of control. Somehow throws up a shot. It's no good. Rebound comes down to the Rangers. Pulling it down was Paschel. They leave it down the floor to McDowell. He'll drive down the left side. Put it up and in. Good. McDowell. Cameron McDowell with the basket. It's going to give him 7 on the night. It's 24 to 20. Weevils lead by 4. Jackson, baseline, kicks it back out front to Brogdon, top of the key to Nelson, swinging left side to Denton. Josh looking inside for Krupa Leah. Rangers staying back in that zone defense, packing it pretty tight. 8 to shoot, here's Nelson for 3, it won't go. Rebound comes away to Paschel for the Rangers, and there's a foul, a reach-in foul called on Alex Brogdon. Alex trying to knock the ball out, got guilty of the reach-in foul, his first. We'll walk to the other end and shoot some free throws. It'll be Dietrich Paschel at the free throw line for the Rangers. shooting the front end of a 1-1. Brogdon's going to go sit down. Donovan Cooper comes back in. Also, Nelson will sit down, and Wesley Booker checks back in for the Bo Weevils. Pascal at the free throw line. First one's up, and it's good. Dietrich, his first point off the bench. Makes it 24-21. UAM with a three-point lead. This can pull the Rangers back to within two, and he does. 24-22. Weevils with a two-point lead. Rangers with a little token pressure here in the backcourt. Cooper gets it across the timeline ahead to Denton. Now leaves it with Booker, and Weevils working. Isaac Jackson, deep outside on the right side. Goes to Cooper on the left side. They go to Kupalia. Bounce pass back door. Goes up to Booker. His shot blocked, taken out of the air by the Rangers. Down the floor, DeRon Clark came out of there with it, and he just checked in for the Rangers. They'll give it up out front to Kennedy Milton. Milton takes the dribble, lost his footing, slides on the floor. They're going to call traveling on Milton. Lost his footing, unfortunate slip there for him. A minute 34 to play here in the half before halftime, 24-22. UAM with a two-point lead. It'll be Weevil basketball. Nelson will check back in. Cooper's going to sit out for the Weevils. Into the front court. Nelson gives it up to Denton. Denton to Jackson. Left side to Booker. Booker, top the key again to Denton. Keep it out on the perimeter. Rangers work it right side. The Weevils do. Get it off to Denton. Denton three-pointer no good. Rebound comes down to Brian Free. Free up the floor to Milton. Back to Free for three. No good. Kupalia gets a rebound. A minute left to play in the half. Weevils still lead by two, and Coach Chad Tapp wants a timeout to talk about it. 24-22 our score. Weevils have the lead. We're going to keep it right here. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Earlier tonight, if you missed it, if you joined us late, in women's action, the Blossoms went down 75-58. They hung with the Lady Rangers through three quarters. They were down by four when we started the fourth. Ended up losing 75-58, the final on the women's side. We've got men's action for you right now, 24-22. Weevils with a two-point lead. UAM's biggest lead has been 10. The Rangers' biggest lead has been four. We've had unofficially six lead changes, one tie throughout this first half so far. UAM will have it out of the timeout. 59 seconds remain before halftime. 24 on the shot clock. Weevils get it in to Isaac Jackson. Jackson gives it up to Zane Nelson. Nelson now back to Booker. Wesley off to Nelson to Jackson to get it to him in the paint. His shot blocked. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Rangers. There'll be 12 seconds on the shot clock. UAM's going to get it on the baseline. Get it in. Kupalia back to Nelson in the right corner. Three-pointer good. Zane Nelson. 7, make it 9 points for him, and the Weevils lead it by five. It's about 12 seconds difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Down the left, inside the lane, Free drives, gets the layup to go. Brian Free, quick move to the basket. Shot clock's off now. Weevils lead it by three. Nelson up ahead, he gets it to Booker. Booker here in the front court, he's finally going to give it up to Nelson. 10 seconds. Nelson at midcourt starts his move. Nelson wants to clear out, fires a long three. It will not go. 1.8 seconds from midcourt at the buzzer. It's off the glass and no good for the Rangers. That's the end of the first half. Our score, UAM 27. The Rangers of Northwest Oklahoma State 24. We'll be back with our halftime activities for you when we return to Steelman Fieldhouse in just a moment.
Weevils going to have your three-point shot to win $100 cash. Sponsored by Union Bank. You'll also be entered to the chance to win a half-court shot at our last home game Saturday, March 2nd against Wichita Baptist for a chance to win $10,000. Let's give it up for Josh. Give him a good hand.
Yeah. Back here at Stillman Fieldhouse, our score 27-24. The Weevils lead it by three. Biggest lead in the first half was 10 for UAM. Biggest lead for the Rangers was four. We did have six lead changes and one tie throughout the first 20 minutes of basketball. Right now, at halftime, the Rangers 8 of 21. That's 38%. They're 4 of 6 from beyond the arc, 67%. And 4 of 4 from the free throw line. UAM shot 10 of 29, so he had 8 more shots there in the first half, 35%. 3 of 12, only 25% from beyond the arc, and they went 4 of 4 from the charity stripe as well. Turnovers, 7 against the Rangers, 4 against the Boll Weevils. Rebounding, UAM out-rebounded them by 1, so the Rangers hit the boards pretty hard the last part of the first half, 15-14. But the Rangers have one offensive rebound, 13 defensive. UAM with 5 offensive rebounds, and that's going to convert into 9 second chance points for the Boll Weevils. They hit the boards pretty hard on the offensive end to get 5 and had 9 second chance points in the first half. Again, our score here at halftime, 27-24. Weevils lead it by 3. We'll take a break. Be back with more at halftime in just a moment.
Thanks for this time. I'd like to recognize our partners who make a solid impact upon UAM Athletics. Union Bank, Showcase of Florida, Commercial Bank, South Arkansas Rehab, Agunk Equipment, Barclays, BASS, Citizens Bank, Clark Contractor, Drew County Farm Bureau, Inforce, Driver, Paul Griffin Shelter Insurance, Paradigm Fitness, Domino's Pizza, Hampton Inn, Holiday Inn and Quality Inn, Mid South Sea, Jefferson Regional Medical Center, Mainline Health System. CR
27. 27-24, the Weevils with a three-point lead here at the half. And I guess you missed it earlier tonight. Blossoms went down 75-58 to the Lady Rangers. We got ball games coming up on Saturday. It'll be every Thursday and Saturday throughout the months of January and February. Great American Conference basketball every Thursday and Saturday. Again, we're at home again this Saturday. And we take on Southwest Oklahoma. Next week, we're on the road. It'll be a swing through East Central and Southeast Oklahoma. We go to Ada, I believe, on Thursday. And Durant on Saturday of next week. But it's time for basketball. Here we are after the first of the year, 2024. Glad you're with us here on KHPM 93.7 FM. I'm Jimmy Sledge. And I'm looking forward for the Weevils and the Blossoms to get on the winning ways, get on the winning side of things here tonight, that hopefully the Weevils can hold on as we're at halftime. They enjoy a three-point lead here at the half. Biggest lead has been 10 for the Weevils. Biggest lead for the Rangers was 4. Individually, looking at scoring in the first half, one player in double figures, and that's for Northwest Oklahoma State, and that is Brian Free. Free went 2 of 4 from beyond the arc, 3 of 6 from the floor. So he ends up 2 of 2 from the free throw line. 10 points, only player in double figures. Then it's 7 points for Cam McDowell. Cameron McDowell with 7 points. 3 points for Justin Norris. 2 points for Dietrich Paschel. And 2 points for Larry White. And that rounds out the scoring for the Rangers. 24 points in the first half. UAM, we got Isaac Jackson leading the way with 9. He and Zane Nelson both have 9 points in the first half. Zane went 3 of 8. So did Isaac, 3 of 8 from the floor. Both of them went 2 for 2 from the free throw line. They end the half with 9 points apiece. Josh Denton ends up with 5 points. 2 points for Cole Anderson coming off the bench, and Donovan Cooper has 2 points coming off the bench for UAM. The Northwest got 12 points off the bench. UAM got 4. So need somebody to come in off the bench and contribute a little bit more for the Weevils here in the second half, as it's 27-24. The Weevils lead by 3. Rebounding, as we said, 15-14. Midway through the half, Weevils had a pretty good size advantage on the rebounding side. The Rangers stepped it up some there in the last half of the first half to kind of even up the rebounding. Halftime score, 27-24, here from Stillman Fieldhouse. Don't go anywhere. More to come when we return after this timeout. That's right. 27-24, the Weevils with a three-point lead on this cool night in January here at Steelman Fieldhouse. Again, we invite you to come out Saturday, 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock are the tip-off times on Saturday. We'll be right back here at home, so we hope you'll come out and watch these young men and young women in basketball action Saturday afternoon, 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock, if you'd like to come out. Numbers here in the first half. Rangers were 8 of 21, 38% from the floor. The Weevils 10 of 29, 35%. Weevils had eight more shots and hit two of them. UAM went 3 of 12 from three-point land, while the Rangers 4 of 6. So they shot 67% from beyond the arc. Weevils shooting 25%. Both teams 4 of 4 from the free throw line. So the officials pretty well let them play. Nobody in foul trouble. Looks like the only one that for UAM that's got two is Zane Nelson. He picked those up early. And then it's Shibangu with two personal fouls and Larry White with two personal fouls for the Rangers. So that's only once. Any kind of nothing serious on the foul side. Both teams made their way back out on the floor. We're just about set for the start of the second half. 27-24. Weevils with a three-point lead here at the intermission. We'll take a break and come back with the start of the second half for you in just a moment. Weevils with a three-point lead. We get set to start the second half. The Rangers are going to have their starting five. Kennedy Milton, Brian Free, Larry White, Marquise Milton, and Kabiya Shibangu for the Weevils. Their original starting five as well. Josh Denton, Zane Nelson, along with Isaac Jackson, and Kupalia on the floor for the Weevils. Weevils have it to start the second half. Three-point jumper on the way from Isaac Jackson, no good. Josh Denton with a rebound, the offensive put back up and in, good. Josh Denton working hard underneath the basket. Got it to go, and the Weevils lead it by five here to start the second half. Rangers looking against that man-to-man defense of the Weevils. They'll work it here out front. That's Brian Free. Free. They get it off to Kennedy Milton. Milton, top of the circle now to White. White back to Free. He'll drive, floater in the paint. No good. Rebound, Weevils have it. UAM with the basketball. Nelson ahead to Denton. Denton leaves it out front with Jackson now. Now they come back to Nelson. Right side to Booker. Wesley off to Denton. Josh Denton. Weevils keep it out on the perimeter. They finally go inside. Kupalia, right-handed hook shot up and in. Good. Tamir Kupalia, his first 2 points of the ball game, and the Weevils have opened up a 7-point lead here to start the second half. Rangers take it. Go left side, get it to Free. Bryan drives all the way underneath the basket, kicks it over in the right corner over to Milton. Marquise takes it to the top of the key, leaves it with Larry White, back to Milton. He'll go in, a little skip hop. Can't get the shot off, finally does. A fadeaway, tough shot, good by Marquise Milton. 31-26, Weevil still lead by five. 18 minutes left to play in this basketball game. Weevils have it, front court, Josh Denton. Leaves it with Booker out front. Now to Jackson, Isaac to Denton to keep it out on the perimeter. Rangers take it down, take the zone in. They're Denton in the right corner for three, and it's good. Josh Denton, his second three of the ball game. That gives him 10. He's the first Weevil to go into double figures. And it's 34-26. Weevils lead it by eight. Here's the Rangers. Ball knocked away by Booker. They're going to call a foul on Wesley Booker. Oh, my. Crowd didn't like it. It's going to be his second personal foul. First team foul against UAM here in the second half. 17:30 to play in the second half. 34-26. Quick three-pointer up in the air. Good by Brian Free. His third three of the game. Going to give him 11, 13 points. Leading score for the Rangers here in the game so far. 34-29. Kupalia from the left elbow. Gives it back to Nelson. He'll go to the free throw line. Trying to squeeze a pass in there. It's knocked away and stolen by the Rangers, stolen right back by the Weevils. It's still loose on the floor. It's going to go out of bounds. And let's see. It's going to go out of bounds. Last touch by UAM, so it belonged to the Rangers. Boy, it's a lot of scrambling for the basketball on that particular possession. I think probably 7 of the 10 players on the floor had a hand on it at one time. 34-29, UAM leads it by five. 16:55 left to play here in the second half. Both teams, no substitutes as of yet. Here in the second half, they wiped up some perspiration on the floor. And all right. Rangers are going to inbound it almost at midcourt. There's 23 seconds on the shot clock. That may be what they're discussing on whether or not should be any more time. That's what they're going to leave. Rangers will get it in as they get it in to Brian Free. Free gives it right back to Marquise Mitten, and they'll bring it up the floor. Mitten goes to White. Larry White drives. We're going to call an offensive charge on Larry White. That's the second one of those tonight. Larry, just a little out of control, lowers his shoulder. There you go. Get called for the offensive charge. His third personal. 16:47 to play. Weevils will get the basketball back. Rangers are going to put some pressure in the backcourt. White will go sit down with that third foul. Chance Love checked into the ball game now for the Rangers. Weevils tried to get it across the timeline. A whistle and a foul going to be called against the Rangers. As a foul is going to go on Brian Free, his first. Second team foul. Wesley Booker was the one that was fouled. He's going to inbound it right here in front of our broadcast position. Get it into Isaac Jackson. Jackson leaves it. Kupalia out front. Nelson, but before that, we had a whistle and a foul called against the Rangers. Oh, the shot clock was not reset to 22. Okay, no foul. So the Weevils will inbound again with 22 on the shot clock. They run the same play. Go to Krupalia, back to Nelson. Nelson in the corner now to Denton. Denton goes to Krupalia down low. Out front to Jackson. Isaac finds Nelson. Nelson penetrates, goes in. Shot's blocked. Taken out of the air by the Rangers. Coming away with it, Brian Free. Down the floor. Going to leave it outside with Justin Norris. Norris from just inside the three-point line. I make that number one. That's Kennedy Milton. His first 2 points of the ball game. Kennedy gets in the scorer's books, and it's 34-31. UAM leads by three. We approach 16 minutes to play in the second half. Weevils with it front court. Booker goes left side to Jackson. Ball stolen away. Breakaway down the floor. Easy. Off the glass and then a slam dunk by the man following. That's Chubanga who got the basket. 1 point ball game, 34-33. Weevils up by a point. Rangers staying back now in a man-to-man defense. Is that what they're in? We'll check that out and see. As Nelson penetrates, goes to the free throw line, dishes it off to Krupalia inside, counted and one. Tamir Krupalia got the basket to go on the inside. As Krupalia is going to go to the line for a chance at a three-point play. The foul went against Kennedy Milton, his first, third team foul, but not before we have a timeout. It's 36-33, I believe, is what we'll see if they mark, put that away. We'll take the break. We'll be back in just a moment. The 2-point basket was good. Krupalia is going to be at the line for a chance at a 3-point play. That was the first personal on Kennedy Milton for the Rangers. The third team foul here in the second half. 15-21 to play, our first media timeout of the second half. And Tamir Krupalia, 4 points, all of them here in the second half, trying to complete the three-point play, and he does. The big guy knocks down the free throw. The Weevils lead it by four. Rangers, front court. Right side, they work it off to Kennedy Milton. Milton back out front now. They go to McDowell. McDowell trying to feed it inside. Ball goes out of bounds off of UAM. They say off Alex Brogdon. It looked like it touched the hands of Chance Love, but the official's right there. The Rangers will have it with 10 seconds on the shot clock. 8 seconds. Down the left side. Inside the lane, shot blocked from behind. Now they say it's a foul called on Isaac Jackson. Looked like he got all ball from behind. Going to put Brian free at the free throw line. Looked like Jackson got all ball from behind, but going to be his second personal, second team foul against the Weevils here in the half. Brian Free, 2 for 2, making 3 out of 3, leading scorer so far tonight on this Ranger basketball team. It's going to give you 12, 14 points. Second one's on the way, bounces around, goes in good. 37-35. Rangers keep hanging around. Weevils lead it by two. Zane Nelson across the timeline to Jackson. Now to Brogdon. Alex. Back to Nelson, to Denton. Denton to Alex Brogdon. Rangers packing it in tight, back in the zone. There's Nelson trying to drive, ball knocked away from behind. It will belong to the Weevils with 6 seconds on the shot clock. UAM will inbound on the baseline. Nelson gets it into Brogdon, 14-foot jumper, in and out, no good. Jackson tips, no good. Then the rebound comes out to Josh Denton. We keep it alive and go back to Jackson. He's got a running 12-foot jumper. It's no good. And now the Rangers get the rebound. That was Chance Love that pulled it down. They'll bring it ahead to Cameron McDowell, and he'll take it down the lane into traffic. Gets a layup to go. Cameron McDowell. We'll give him 9 points in the game, and it's 37-37. We're all tied. It's only our second tie of the game. Had six lead changes and two ties now. They're all tied up at 37 apiece. Weevils with the basketball. Rupalia got it to Denton out front to Nelson. Nelson thought about the three. Goes to Denton. Denton goes down the line. Two on the shot clock. Nelson gets the floater in the lane to go. Nelson with 12, or makes it Denton with 12. Josh Denton. UAM regains the lead, 39-37, 13-21 to play here in the second half. Rangers work it off to Brian Free. Free will fire the three. He's not scared. They're going to call, let's see, a whistle and a foul, maybe away from the basketball. The foul is going to go on Alex Brogdon. It was away from the shot, but Alex is going to be guilty of the foul. His second. Team foul number three. And the Rangers will get it on the baseline here. Kupalia will check out. Cole Anderson comes into the ballgame now for UAM. Rangers. They take it into the paint. Milton travels with the basketball. He got out of control. Travel with it. Marquise turns it over. Weevils are going to get it back with 13:09 to play, leading 39-37. Get some pressure here in the backcourt. They run a trap. They try to trap it at half court. Weevils have done a pretty good job with it most of the night here. They get it across the timeline again. Into the front court. Alex Brogdon with it. They go to Anderson from the elbow, left side. He'll leave it to Nelson on the baseline. He forces the shot up. Whistle. They call a foul on the floor before the shot. See who the foul's on. It gets on the Rangers. The foul is going to go on Chance Love. His second personal foul. Team's fourth. So the Weevils are going to inbound on the baseline. Zane Nelson will inbound it, get it into Jackson. Isaac. Been quiet most of the night. He quietly has 11 points. There's Brogdon inside. Brogdon goes up with a shot, whistle, and we're going to call the foul inside against the Rangers for reaching in. The foul is going to go on Marquise Milton. His first. And Alex Brogdon is going to get to go to the line. Alex has not scored in the game. He'll be shooting two shots here. With 12:39 to play in the ball game, it's 39-37. Weevils with a two-point lead. Brogdon at the line, free throws on the way, good. 2-4, Weevils are 6 out of 6 from the line. Rangers are 6 out of 6 from the line so far. Second one's on the way, good. Make them 7 out of 7. And the Weevils lead it by 4, 41-37. Ranger basketball as they trail. Cameron McDowell. They get it right side, three-pointer on the way, is up, hits the back of the iron, gets hung up on top of the backboard, in between the top of the backboard and the shot clock. So it'll be a dead ball, and the Weevils are going to get it back. Need somebody a little taller than Zane to get it out. They finally knock it down. It'll be UAM basketball. there in the backcourt. With 12:27 left to play in the game, UAM up by four, 41-37. Shibango is going to check into the ball. Shibango is going to check into the ball game now for the Rangers as Paschal sits down. Nelson, Brogdon, Jackson, Denton, and Anderson on the floor for the Bull Weevils. UAM into the front court, 15 on the shot clock. They work it to Denton, to Brogdon out on the right wing, to Jackson now. Isaac looking inside for Anderson, trying to bounce pass. Ball's going to be kicked out of bounds. They'll put a 20 back up on the shot clock. So the Weevils will inbound right next to our broadcast position. Just to the right of us here. Brogdon gets it in to Jackson. Now to Anderson. Off to Nelson. Nelson top of the key. Right side to Denton. Out front it goes to Nelson, and Nelson travels with the basketball. Started to go up with the three. His man was contesting the shot, so he pulled it down, but he drug his pivot foot. We got a timeout on the floor. 11:55 to play in the basketball game. It's 41-37. Weevils leading. We're back in just a moment. And the Weevils with the four-point lead. Here in the second half, Northwest Oklahoma State, 5 of 7, 71% from the floor, 1 of 2 from beyond the arc, 2 of 2 from the free throw line. The Weevils here in the second half, 5 of 10, that's 50%, 1 of 3 from downtown, and 3 of 3 from the free throw line. They come out of the timeout. Rangers have the basketball. They try to work it down low. Get it back out front now to Milton. Marquise, three-pointer on the way, no good. We will see a foul on the floor. Going to be called on Cole Anderson, I believe. Nope. See the, yep, Cole Anderson, his second personal foul. So Cole with his second. Team foul number four against the Weevils. Rangers inbound it. They get it in the corner. A three-point shot on the way. Good by Brian Free. His fourth three-pointer of the ball game. 14, 16 points for Brian Free. And it's 41-40. Weevils up by one now. Rangers have not led in the second half. We get down to 11-12 left to play in the game. Isaac Jackson takes the dribble, goes down into the lane, trying to go left side. Brogdon threw it away. Kind of a no-look pass, and it missed Brogdon by about 3 feet. So the Rangers with a chance to take the lead this trip into the front court. We'll go under 11 minutes left to play. Weevils staying a man-to-man. Down the floor, inside the paint, running jumpers up, no good, but a whistle and a foul called on the Bull Weevils, as that was Cameron McDowell who made the move. And that's going to be Anderson picking up his third personal foul. And that's going to bring Tamir Kupalia back up off the bench. Anderson will come out here in just a moment. At the free throw line is going to be Cameron McDowell shooting two shots here. First free throw is on the way. Could tie the ball game. Doesn't do it. Misses it off the front of the rim. No good. Brogdon will come out. Anderson comes out. Kupalia checks back in, and Josh Denton checks back in for the Weevils. All right. Cameron McDowell, one more opportunity to tie the ball game here at 41, and he does. Our third tie of the game. 10:54 to play. Zane Nelson, Wesley Booker. There's a steal by the Rangers. Weevils throw it away. They work it left side. They go to Milton. Milton trying to drive. He's going to be fouled by Kupalia out on the floor. He was reaching around trying to knock the ball out. 10:42 to play. They're going to go look at it and see if it was a flagrant foul or not, I believe. 41-41. We're all tied. Again, it's only our third tie of the ball game. We've had six lead changes. The Weevils led at halftime, 27-24. And the biggest lead has been eight here in the second half. Rangers have tied it up twice but have not led in the second half of basketball. So the officials are, I believe, checking to see if it was a flagrant foul or not. Kupalia is the one that reached around. And Brian Free went to the floor when he reached around, but I'm not sure there'll be enough evidence to say it was a flagrant foul or not. Coming up this Saturday, 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock of the tip-off time, Southwest Oklahoma State will be in town. And we'll have the broadcast for you beginning a little before 1 on Saturday afternoon with the women's game and somewhere around 3 o'clock men's game right here on KHPM 93.7, your home of UAM basketball. So I hope you'll make plans to come out. If you can't, we'll join us right here on the radio for more UAM basketball. And again, we're getting started off. 2024 starts it off every Thursday and Saturday throughout January and February. We'll have Great American Conference basketball here on the radio. And the officials are, well, they want to get it right, make sure what's going on. 10:42 to play. Second half, we're all tied 41-41. Both teams have identical records coming in conference play. Both teams were 1-3 in conference play coming into tonight's game. So, you know, both teams would like to get 2024 started off with a win. That's the officials still looking at the replay monitors. I see Coach Tapp trying to look over the shoulder. See what he can see what they're looking at. Anyway, we wanted to remind you that we'll be back here on Saturday, then next week, the first road trip of 2024 will take us out to Ada, Oklahoma, and Durant, Oklahoma, East Central and Southeastern. It'll be next Thursday and Saturday, 1 week from tonight. And both coaches now are up near midcourt, awaiting the decision of the officials. Let's see. Explaining it to the official scorekeeper on the other side. And to the PA announcer. Now they're going to explain it to each of the coaches, and they are going to call it a flagrant foul, it looks like. So we'll send to the free throw line Brian Free. And then the Rangers are going to get the basketball back. Be two shots for Brian Free. And he is 4 out of 4, making 5 out of 5 as he makes the first one. 16 points in the ballgame. I have him with 17. 16. He'll have one more free throw. That gives them their first lead of the second half at 42-41. He makes the second free throw. 17 points now on the night for Brian Free. And the Rangers lead it by two, their biggest lead of the second half, first lead of the second half. And they'll get the basketball back. And the foul was on Krupalia. Now a whistle and a foul away from the basketball, and it's on the Weevils. The foul is going to go. They get that one on. Coach Shantap going to call a timeout, try to regroup everybody. 43-41. It is a 1-1 situation, so when we come back, they will be shooting free throws. As this is a 30-second. No, they made it a full timeout. We'll take it with them and be back with more UAM basketball in just a moment. It's 43-41. Northwest has taken their first lead of the second half. They've outscored the Weevils 19-14 here in the second half so far. We had a flagrant foul called against Krupalia. They made both of those free throws. Then on the entry pass, as they got the ball back, the Rangers did, there was another foul called on Krupalia. Away from the basketball, we're in the 1-1 situation. Chance Love's at the line for the Rangers, shooting the front end of the 1-1. It's on the way, rattles around and goes home. 44-41, Rangers had their biggest lead back in the first half was 4. Second free throw from Love's up and good. And that will make it a 4-point lead again for the Rangers here in the second half. So you take it all, and all in all, it was a 4-point swing for the Rangers. And it gives them a lead. There's a ball knocked away from Nelson. Larry White goes up with a shot, but he is fouled on the way up, and he's going to get to go to the line too. The foul goes on Zane Nelson. Zane has just picked up his third personal foul. Team foul number 8, Larry White, going to go to the line for the Rangers. He scored 2 points in the ball game. He's got into foul trouble. He's been on the bench most of the night. He had 2 in the first half, picked one up early in the second half for 3. That one rattles around and goes home. Makes it 46-41, a 5-point lead. Can stretch it to 6 with this free throw. It's on the way, and it's good. 47-41, a 6-0 swing by the Rangers has given them a 6-point lead. Again, pressure in the backcourt. Nelson gets it up ahead, and they throw it away. It goes through the hands of Tyreon King, who had just checked in for UAM. So Rangers are going to get it back. It's been a 6-point swing. They can make it a 8 or 9-point swing. Zane Nelson's going to come out of the ball game as Donovan Cooper is going to check in now for the Weevils. Currently on a 7-0, I'll make it a 6-0 run. The Rangers, with a six-point lead, have the basketball here at the front court. They get it off to Cameron McDowell. McDowell goes right side over to Milton. Marquise for three. It's in and out, no good. And going high was Tyreon King to get the rebound for the Bow Weevils. Cooper off to King, now to Denton, back to Cooper. Right side, they come to Isaac Jackson. Down by six, the Weevils need a basket this trip into the front court. Under 10 to play. Cooper with under eight to shoot on the play clock, on the shot clock. Cooper almost lost a handle on it. Fires a desperation three. It's no good. Hit the rim. Denton with an offensive rebound and throws it away. Rebound. The ball stolen by the Rangers as they come up with a loose basketball. The Rangers with a six-point lead have it here in the front court again. They get it left side, free for three. Brian Free nails it. I have that as his fifth three of the ball game, and the Rangers are up by 10. They'll make it nine, and the Weevils call another timeout. With 9:17 to play in the basketball game, they're currently on a 9-0 run. They lead it 50-41, and it all started back with a flagrant foul called against Tamir Kupalia. As you had Brian Free stepped up, knocked down those two free throws. Rangers got the ball back, and Weevils made a foul on the entry pass. They made the front end of the 1-1. Then the Weevils fouled again, and it was 6 points from the free throw line for the Rangers to give them a six-point lead. And then just right there just a moment ago, a three-pointer by Brian Free. I've got him with 20 points on the night, Brian Free is. And it's 50-41. Rangers with a 9-point lead. Weevils with the basketball. Isaac Jackson gives it back to Nelson. Nelson back to Jackson. Isaac, free throw line, bounce pass down low, trying to go to Kupalia. Ball knocked away and stolen by the Rangers. Under 9 minutes to play. Again, Rangers currently on a 9-0 run. They work it outside to McDowell. McDowell almost gets tied up. Traveling called as it was Tyreon King really putting the pressure there on McDowell. And McDowell kind of got frustrated. He thought he was fouled. When he came up and looked at the official, he traveled with the basketball. So the Weevils are going to get it back, but they need a basket this trip into the front court. Wesley Cooper is checked back in. Isaac Jackson's gone out. Now for UAM. Coming in for the Rangers is going to be Kennedy Milton. And Cameron McDowell will go out of the ball game. Weevils in the front court. Wesley Booker off to Josh Denton. Denton off to King. King. They leave it out front now with Nelson. Zane trying to drive right side of the lane. Double teamed over there. Shots high, no good. Wesley Booker with a rebound. The tip put back up and in by Kupalia. Demir Kupalia with a tip in, and that ends a scoring drought for the Weevils. 50-43 now. Rangers with a 7-point lead, 8 minutes to play. Rangers with it front court. Shibunga, they go inside, ball knocked away and stolen by the Weevils. Down the floor comes Nelson. Nelson gives it up outside to King. King has it stripped out of his hands, but he gets it back. Finds Denton all alone, top of the key, good. Josh Denton, his third three of the game. 15 points for Josh Denton. And the Weevils currently on a 5-0 run and made it a 4-point ball game. Down on the other end, stop, jump, ball blocked from behind. That was Larry White's shot blocked from behind by Kupalia. Weevils take it out of the air, and here comes UAM back into the front court. Denton off to King. King now to Booker. Booker to Nelson. Nelson Guarded out there by Larry White. Nelson takes him down the lane left. It's a layup to go. Zane Nelson. Got him with 9-11 in the ball game for Zane. The Weevils have cut it to two. Currently on a 7-0 run for the Weevils. Under 7 minutes to play now. White with it for the Rangers out top of the key. Goes off to Marquise Milton. Milton gets it off to Kennedy Milton. Milton, he'll drive, goes in the paint, dishes it off inside to the big guy, Shabanga. Shabanga puts it up and in. Good. 4 points for Shabanga. All of them here in the second half, and it's 52-48. Rangers lead it by four. Weevils across the timeline, get it into the front court now. Booker out on the right side, top of the key to Denton. Off to King. King leads it back to Booker. Now to Nelson with 10 to shoot. Nelson to the left elbow. Kupalia back to Nelson. Three-pointer, turn around, shot up, no good. Wesley Booker chases down a long rebound, keeps it alive for UAM. He'll go into the paint. Spin move goes up, no good. A whistle and bodies on the floor. Booker goes down hard. Now let's see who the foul is on, or if there is a foul. And we're going to see if this is a flagrant foul, it looks like. And they got Larry White. He's got a little attitude going on. The foul is going to go against the Rangers. And it should be Wesley Booker. Foul goes on Marquise Milton. That's who they called the foul on. They sent both teams to the benches for the timeout. 52-48, our score. Weevils down by four, 6 minutes exactly left to play in this basketball game. It's gotten kind of sloppy and kind of hard to keep up with, but we're going to take a break. We'll come back in just a moment. It's 52-48. Weevils down by four. There's 6 minutes left to play. The officials are still looking at the monitors, and I think they're trying to determine if it was a flagrant foul against the Rangers. They called a personal foul on Marquise Milton. But Larry White was really upset when he went off the floor. Still got both teams at their respective benches, and officials are still looking at the monitor to see what they can do. 6 minutes remaining. It seems like it takes them a long time to look at that replay monitor. Don't forget, Saturday, we're back in action here as Southwestern Oklahoma State comes to town. It'll be 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock with the tip-off times on Saturday. So I hope you'll come out and join us here at Steelman Fieldhouse. If you can't make it, of course, keep it right here on the radio. And I said two shots, but we don't know if it was a flagrant foul or just a regular foul. Looks like it's going to be a regular foul. And at the free throw line, it's going to be Wesley Booker. So Wesley's going to go to the free throw line for UAM. He has not scored in the ball game. He had the line shooting two shots. 52-48. Weevils down by four. Booker's first free throw is up, and it is good. Can pull the Weevils back to within two. If he can make this free throw. Free throw is up, off the front of the rim, will not go. Rebound, Rangers have it. So 52-49, Rangers lead it by three. They'll have it here in the front court. Brian Free leaves it out front to McDowell. McDowell, they work it back left side, get it over here to Kennedy Milton. Back to Free. Brian drives, goes along the baseline, pulls up from the jumper, no good. Rebound, a whistle, and a foul on the rebound again, and Booker's back on the floor. And we're going to walk to the other end and shoot some free throws. The foul is going to go against the Rangers. Chance Love, his third personal. That's team foul number seven. So both teams are in the bonus. With 5:36 left to play, we're going to put Wesley Booker back at the free throw line. He's one out of two from the free throw line here tonight. Free throws up, front end of the one and one, and he missed it. Rebound comes off. Rangers have it, stolen away by Josh Denton. Denton tried to go to Kupalia. He wasn't ready for it, but maintains possession. They'll reset, go into the half-court offense. They work it out on the perimeter now to Denton. Denton to Nelson. Left side, Jackson, who just checked in. A three-pointer on the way, and it's good! Isaac Jackson, his second three of the game. He's got 14 points on the night, and the Weevils have tied it up. We're all tied at 52-52 with 5 minutes left to play in the basketball game. Kennedy Milton drives to the elbow on the right side, leaves it back out front to McDowell. McDowell now drives into the paint, travels with the basketball. Got tied up in traffic, good defense by the Weevils. And McDowell couldn't stop his momentum, travels with the basketball. Weevils with a chance to regain the lead. We've had six lead changes and four ties throughout the ball game. Three of those ties coming here in the second half. Only one lead change in the second half. Jackson off to Booker. Booker now to Nelson. Nelson guarded out there by Brian Free. Nelson takes it, pulls up, 14-foot fadeaway jumper, no good. Rebound comes away to the Rangers. It's coming out there with it is Chance Love. All tied at 52, 4:14 left to play. Every possession means something now. As we go under 4 minutes left to go. There's Milton driving, goes to the elbow, kicks it back outside. Love for three, and it's good. Chance Love with the three-pointer. 55-52. Rangers on top by three. They try to trap at half court. Nelson picked up his dribble, throws it across the timeline into the front court to Denton. Denton double teamed. Denton, let's see, I think he's going to be fouled. Yep, the foul is going to go against the Rangers, and the foul is going to go on Cameron McDowell. They had Josh Denton trapped right there in front of the scorer's table. And then we've got a timeout on the floor, and then we'll come back and shoot some free throws. 55-52. Rangers have a three-point lead. We're back after this timeout. 55-52. The Rangers with a three-point lead. 3:42 to play in the ballgame. At the free throw line for UAM is going to be Josh Denton. Denton having with 15 points in the ballgame, his first appearance at the line. And he's shooting two shots here. Make it the 1-1. First one is up and no good. In and out. Wow. Normally a 88% free throw shooter missed the first one. Rangers have it coming the other way. They got it down and go in the corner now off to Kennedy Milton. Milton leaves it out front now with Brian Free. 10 on the shot clock. Free with the dribble. Goes down, gets it up in the air to Kennedy Milton. Milton with a fadeaway from just inside the free throw line. Good. 57-52. Rangers up by five. They've led by as many as nine here in the second half. Wesley Booker gets it to Jackson. And Coach Tapp called it. Coach Tapp called the timeout while the Weevils were trying to get set up in their half-court offense. It's a full timeout again with 3 minutes left to play in the ballgame. 57-52. Rangers lead it. We're back in a moment. Minutes left to play in the basketball game. Rangers have a five-point lead, 57-52. It'll be UAM basketball out of the timeout, 19 seconds on the shot clock. Weevils have Wesley Booker, Tamir Kupalia, Isaac Jackson, Zane Nelson, and Josh Denton on the floor for the Weevils. They get it to Nelson, now to Denton. Denton back to Nelson. Six to shoot. Nelson drives, floater, left side of the lane. His shot blocked. Gets it off to Booker, and a shot clock violation by the Boll Weevils. 2:39 left to play, and the Rangers force a shot clock violation by the Boll Weevils. So the Rangers are going to get it back. UAM has one timeout remaining. Rangers have two. With 2:35 left to play in the ball game. Free, he'll give it up to Kennedy Milton. They work it right side, get it off to McDowell. McDowell, top of the key, it goes to Milton again. Three-pointer on the way, and it's good! Brian Free, his sixth three of the game. And the Rangers have an eight-point lead. 60-52. It's a 30-second timeout called. I believe Coach Tapp called it. 60-52. 2:19 remaining. As we'll keep it right here. The Weevils led. At this point, they led 22 minutes of the ball, 22 and a half minutes of the ball game. Rangers have led 12 and a half minutes of the game. We've had seven lead changes and four ties throughout the game. Biggest lead for UAM has been 10 in the game. Biggest lead for the Rangers has been 9. They currently lead it by 8, 60-52. UAM will have the basketball in the backcourt with 2:19 remaining. Zane Nelson, Wesley Booker, Isaac Jackson, Josh Denton, and Cooper Leah on the floor. Nelson, they trap him, they get it, gets rid of it, gets it across the timeline, ahead to Denton in the front court. Jackson, right side to Nelson. Zane gives it back to Jackson, back to Nelson. Nelson drives, goes baseline, forces a shot up, it won't go, but he's fouled. He's going to get to go to the free throw line. As a foul, he's going to go on Chance Love. Going to be his fourth personal, ninth team foul. And at the free throw line, it's going to be Zane Nelson for the Weevils. Zane, two out of two from the free throw line tonight, shooting two here. First one's up, in and out, no good. Down the stretch, the Weevils have missed their last four free throws. Nelson at the line again. Nelson at the line again. He has 9, 11 points in the game. Free throws up. This one's good. So that'll make it 60-53. Weevils with pressure in the backcourt. They go in the corner, forced a turnover. Nelson with a layup. And count it. And one. As Zane went in hard to the basket. Moving in under him was Brian Free. He'll get called for the foul. Nelson's still on the floor. He hadn't gotten up yet. Teammates are going to help him get up. And he'll be at the line trying to complete a three-point play. It is 60-55. Weevils have cut it down to five. Nelson trying to walk it off. He's out here near midcourt. And cut it to four with a free throw with a minute 52 to play.
Nelson, one shot.
A minute 52 left to play in the ball game, and Zane Nelson at the line trying to complete a three-point play here. It's up, and it is good. Wheels again with pressure, down by four. Brian Free will trigger it in. Gets it into McDowell. McDowell ahead, gets it up the floor, and they'll cross the timeline. They get it to Kennedy Milton. Milton goes underneath the basket. Shot going to be put up off the glass, no good. Rebound, chased down in the corner by the Rangers. And then knocked away, loose on the floor. Rangers are going to pick it up, and a whistle and a foul called. The foul is going to be called on Isaac Jackson, I believe. Yep. Isaac Jackson is going to go off of the reach-ahead foul, his third. Team foul number 9 against the Weevils. A minute 34 to play. That's going to send to the free throw line Chance Love. Love will go to the line. Rangers are 13 out of 14 shooting free throws on the night. And they're going to be shooting the front end of a 1-1 here. With a minute 34 left to play, Rangers with a 4-point lead. Love with 5 points in the game. First free throws up off the back of the rim. No good. Wesley Booker gets the rebound. The Weevils down by four. They come across the timeline and they'll use their final timeout. Coach Chad Tapp calls the final timeout with a minute 29 to play in the ball game. Weevils down by four. This is a full timeout. We'll take it with them and be back with more. Stay with me, Jason. It's just a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here. 60-56. This all started when Weevils led most of the second half. When it was 41-41. The Rangers went on a 9-0 run. The Weevils were able to tie it up twice since then. But right now, the Rangers lead it by four, 60-56, with a minute 29 left to play. And UAM used their final timeout of the ball game. Rangers will still have one. Kupalia, Denton, Booker, Jackson, and Nelson on the floor for the Weevils. We're all set to go. The officials say, let's play ball. Zane Nelson will trigger it in front of the scorer's table. He gets it in to Isaac Jackson. 20 on the shot clock. They work it around. Get it to Denton. Denton back to Nelson. Zane looking for a clear out. Takes it down the right side underneath the basket. Reverse layup partially blocked, but a foul going to be called. Zane's going to get to go to the free throw line. As a foul goes against Shibunga. It's going to be his third personal. And at the line is going to be Zane Nelson. Zane is 4 out of 5 shooting free throws. He hit his last two. First one's on the way. Good. They'll make it 60-57. He'll have one more chance. With a minute 14 left to play. And again, UAM's out of timeouts. Rangers have one left. Second free throw. Rims out. No good. Rangers pull the rebound down. Chance Love did for the Rangers. They'll walk it across the timeline as he'll give it up. That's going to be McDowell with the basketball to Free. Swing it right side to Love. Back out top of the key to McDowell. Weevils in a man-to-man. Shot clock down to 9. McDowell gets it in the hands of Brian Free. He'll penetrate along the baseline. And let's see, whistle and a foul going to be called. Coach Chad Tapp is upset. He thought it should have been a travel call. They called a foul, though, on the inside, and they called the foul on Wesley Booker. His third personal, 10th team foul. So it's going to put the Rangers at the line. Shooting free throws will be Brian Free. He's 5 out of 6 from the line. He has 23 points on the night. As Alex Brogdon's going to check back into the ball game. Wesley Booker say he just fouled out of the ball game. All right. So Brogdon will check in. At the free throw line, Brian Free. On the way, good. That'll extend their lead to 4. 61-57. 48 seconds remain. The Weevils are out of timeouts. Free will have one more. Second free throw is up, and it is good. 62-57. Weevils down by 5. And get it into Isaac Jackson. Jackson quickly into the front court to Denton. Weevils going to have to hurry up and shoot. They go to Nelson. Nelson drives, goes underneath, draws contact, and a whistle and a foul going to be called against the Rangers. And we're going to put Nelson on the free throw line. Yes. See who got the foul on that one for the Rangers. Nelson's going to shoot 2 shots. I believe it went on number 23. That is Shibunga, his 4th personal. Nelson's free throw's on the way. Good. Going to make it a 4-point game, 62-58. Rangers lead it by 4. Second free throw by Nelson's up. It's good. 3-point ball game with 35 seconds remaining. Weevils with pressure in the backcourt. They got him trapped. The ball is going to go, let's see, timeout called. Timeout got called from the bench for Northwest Oklahoma State. Good call. They get it called with 33 seconds left. 33 seconds remaining. That's the final timeout for Northwest Oklahoma State as well. We'll take the break with them. This is the 60-second timeout. We're back in a moment. 33 seconds remain. It's 62-59. Rangers with a three-point lead. They used their final timeout. And the Rangers are going to inbound it 94 feet away against pressure from UAM. UAM trying to trap it in the corner. They got a chance at it. Ball comes out of there, and the Rangers break the press as they bring it into the front court. Now the Weevils are going to have to foul as they reach in. Loose basketball, jump ball is going to be called, I believe, and the Rangers are going to have it on the out. Nope, they call a foul on the Rangers. Call a foul on Brian Free. His third personal, and Isaac Jackson is going to go to the free throw line for UAM. Isaac, 2 out of 2 from the line. That was back in the first half. He'll be shooting two shots here. The Weevils trail by 3, 62-59, 19 seconds remaining. Jackson's first free throw is up, and it is good. Weevils for the ball game now are 13 of 18 from the free throw line. One more free throw can pull the Weevils to within one. Free throw's up. It is good. Neither team has a timeout. 19 seconds remain. Weevils with pressure in the backcourt. Free looking to get it in. He gets it into McDowell. McDowell back to Free. They'll break the press into the front court. And then a whistle and a foul going to be called against UAM. The foul is going to go on Tarion King. His first. And that's going to put the Rangers at the line with 15 seconds remaining. And at the line is going to be Brian Free. 7 out of 8, shooting two shots. 25 points on the night for the Rangers. Brian Free, he'll be shooting two shots here. 62-61, the first one's up, it's good. Brogdon will check in, King will go back out for the Weevils. Still could be a one possession game even if he makes this free throw. It's 63-61 at the moment. Second free throw's up, 64-61. 15 seconds remain. Rangers back off on the press. Weevils into the front court. Can set it up, 10. Isaac Jackson gets to Denton. Denton for 3, it's off the mark, no good. Nelson with an offensive rebound, has it stripped from behind and stolen away, and now a foul going to be called as Nelson trying to catch up. The clock expired. The clock expired before, or after, actually they called the foul before the clock expired. It's not going to change anything, but they're going to go to the monitor and check it anyway and see. The foul goes against Zane Nelson for reaching in. All right, so Zane's going to get the foul. There's no time left on the clock at the moment. But they're going to go look at the monitor. And we know that Kennedy Milton's going to be at the free throw line. They're going to see if how much time they need to put back on the clock. He'll be shooting two shots. Neither team has a timeout remaining. It's 64-61. Rangers with the three-point lead here. It was 27-24 at the half. Weevils had a three-point lead. Rangers have a three-point lead with no time on the game clock left, but they're going to put a little bit of time, probably not much, maybe 3 or 4 tenths of a second. There won't be much time. And the Rangers are shooting two free throws. But, didn't take them long to look at that. They're going to walk over and explain it to the clock keeper. They'll put 1.3 seconds. That's more than I thought they would put back up there. But the Rangers will be at the line leading by 3, 64-61. It'll be Kennedy Milton at the line. He has 4 points in the ball game, his first trip to the free throw line tonight. The Rangers as a team have shot 17 of 19 free throws. 17 of 19 free throws. First one's on the way, off the front, no good. Weevils still have a chance. If he misses this one, it's still a one-possession game. Three-point ball game. Second free throw is up. Now it's a two-possession game as he makes that one. Four-point ball game. Long pass down the floor, goes out of bounds. And the Rangers are going to get it back on the baseline. The Weevils threw it out, so they'll come back down where the Weevils threw it in from. You're going to get it in. Basket's no good. Final score, 65-61. 65-61. And we got some players that are little tempers flaring down on the other end. They're going to get them separated, and everybody's going to head toward the dressing room. Oh, wow. Our final score, 65-61. Rangers get the win here on the road. The Weevils will fall to 1-4 in conference play. The Rangers are going to advance to 2-3 in conference play. And making his way over here to join us here on the postgame show is going to be Coach Chad Tapp. And Coach, boys, let one fail. I can't let one slip away there at the end.
Yeah, we did. You know, we turned it over too much in the second half. And then we weren't as good defensively. That's a major issue. But, you know, I'll say that. That's been a major point of emphasis for us coming back from the break. Get better defensively. I thought we were for the most part. Second half, not so much. And we had some things not go our way.
Yeah.
But this is the best we've battled in a while.
Boy, a lot of free throws shot tonight. They were 18 of 21. We're 15 of 20. A lot of free throws. Yeah. What can you say to that?
Yeah.
It was. You know, and you go back and look. Some of the players coming back after the break, we saw a couple of different faces out on the floor some tonight. And so you're trying to still get some chemistry work together, I guess, aren't you?
Yeah, you know, it's crazy. We had guys starting, not feeling real well, decide he's not going to play at all. He let us know that when we tried to sub him in. So that is what it is. But, you know, it's we've had some we're trying to get some chemistry right now. And yeah. I think, you know, Donovan Cooper came in there and gave us really good minutes in the first half. That helped. So, yeah, we're trying to get some guys, get a rotation, get some guys figure out, try to play. And what we've done coming back from the regulars is said we're going to play the guys that we think will fight for us. So go from there.
All right, well, we got another game on Saturday. Like I say, it doesn't get any easier. Here we go. Saturday, Southeastern comes to town, but we're back at home. But we need to.
Southwestern, yeah.
Yeah, oh, Southwestern, I mean.
Yeah, don't put that on me right now.
Yeah, Southwestern's coming to town, but we need to kind of protect things at home, and that's been tough to do this year.
Wins in general have been tough. You know, we just we got some new faces, and I don't think we've had a lot of leadership out of our older guy or returning guys, but I think we're starting to get that.
All right, Coach. Well, thank you for coming by. We'll see you on Saturday.
All right, thank you.
Coach Tapp joining us here on our postgame show. Final score, 65-61. The Rangers of Southwestern Oklahoma get the win here tonight on the road. And kind of look at some individual things that go on. Like I said, it was 27-24 at halftime. The Weevils had a three-point lead. So we get outscored, what, 41-34 to lose it here tonight, 65-61. All right, that's going to about do it for us here tonight. Looking at some of the final numbers for you unofficially. Brian Free is going to finish the ball game with 15, 24, 26 points for him. And then it was Cameron McDowell finishes in double figures. He had 10. He's only two players in double figures for the Rangers, I believe. That's unofficially. With all the extracurricular activities, we hadn't got any official stats yet. For UAM, Zane Nelson's going to finish the ball game in double figures as he goes 8 of 9 from the free throw line. So that's 11, 19 points for him. Isaac Jackson finishes with 16 points on the night. And Josh Denton will finish with 15 points on the night. But the Weevils come up short, 65-61, the final score. Rangers get the win here at Stillman Fieldhouse. Earlier tonight, it was the Blossoms falling to the Lady Rangers, 75-58, the final score in that one. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of UAM basketball here on KHBM 93.7 FM. We're back on the air Saturday, 1 o'clock with a tip-off of the women's game and 3 o'clock with a tip-off of the men's game. So I hope you'll join us for that. For Jason Camden back at the station, I'm Jimmy Sledge. Good night, everyone.